Hello and welcome. In this video, we are discussing different age detection techniques in image processing and machine vision. For ourselves, human being, human visual system has inherent quality to segment the image, means we can easily recognize different objects in the image, like different faces, shape of the object, different hand gestures, each and every part of the image we can recognize easily. When we want to develop automated system for this work, like hand gesture recognition system, face recognition system, we need to extract important features from the image so that from that features, computer can take the decision and recognize the object. And we can say here our machine vision starts. So age detection is the most important part of the computer vision or machine vision. To identify the objects in the image, ages is the most important feature which we need to extract. Now let us see, what do you mean by ages in the image? An age in an image is a significant local change in the intensity, or we can say discontinuity in the intensity. Let us take this image. Here, this is a background and this is one of the object. So here, at this age, the intensity changes. So this is nothing but discontinuity in the intensity or change in the intensity, and we have to detect this age. Here also for different objects, the ages, at ages, the intensity changes. For each object, at ages, the intensity of the object changes. So we have to detect this, where the change into intensity starts, and that is nothing but the ages. So ages typically occur on the boundary between two different regions in an image. Now let us explore more on these ages in the images. An age is a set of connected pixels that lie on a boundary of or boundary between two regions. Let us take this image. Here intensities are black and gray. So age is the set of the pixel that separates black region from the gray region. This is a step age profile. So if you see, the transition between the one intensity to another intensity is very sharp. So this age profile is the step age. This type of sharp transition or step age you will find only in artificially generated images on a computer. It is not happen in a real world images. Now why? We all know how we are obtaining an image by a digital camera. Digital means whatever the real world scene we are digitizing by the sensing devices used in a camera. These sensing devices perform low pass filtering or smoothing on an image. Means exactly what? In real world scene, maximum frequency present in the image is infinite. And we all know for digitization process, we are applying Noikis criteria. What is that? The sampling rate should be twice of the maximum frequency exists in the image. And the maximum frequency in real world images is infinite. So we need to limit this infinite frequency of real world to some maximum frequency so that we can apply the Noikis criteria. So for this, the images has to pass through the anti-aliasing filter to remove very high frequencies in the image. And this is done by the sensing devices in a digital camera. This anti-aliasing filter is nothing but low-pass filter. And we all know the effect of low-pass filtering. It blur the edges, it smooth the edges, or we can say it smooth the high-frequency component. And all the edges are the high-frequency components. The transition into the intensity is nothing but the high-frequency components in the image. So thus, this anti-aliasing filter reduces the sharp transition to the slope or rampage, like this. So instead of sharp transition, the gray level changes slightly or gradually, and then it becomes gray. It is not a sharp transition between this black to the gray. It is like a age profile is RAM. It the sharp transition edge is transferred into the RAM or some slope. Due to this, when the real world images are captured by camera, we don't have the step edge. The step edges becomes the ramp edges because of the anti-aliasing filtering. Detection of edges. Detection of edges is nothing but detection of discontinuity in the intensity in an image. There are three basic types of gray level discontinuities in a digital images. Points. When there is a point, it is also discontinuity in the image or change in the intensity. Lines and edges. So these are the discontinuity we found in the images. Point, line, edges is nothing but change into the intensity, means all are the high frequency components. So to detect these components, we need to use the high pass filtering mask. Edges. How we'll get the edges in the image? Edges are due to variation of scene features like brightness, then type of material, surface structure, lighting condition gives us edges in the image. Edges represent discontinuity in intensity. To detect these edges, that means to detect the discontinuity, or we can say change in the gray level, we are using derivative approach. And how to do this? This is done by calculating the local gradient operator. The local gradient is a two-dimensional equivalent of the first derivative. The gradient can be numerically approximated by using standard finite difference approximation for the first partial derivative in x and y direction. Now let us see what is this, or how to obtain this finite difference approximation or gradient approach. To understand the gradient concept, here I have considered 9 pixels or 3x3 structure in the image. Now gradient of fxy image is gradient in x direction, gradient in y direction. So df by dx, df by dy. It is approximated by finite difference, means what? In x direction, the next pixel in x direction minus the present pixel. Fx plus 1, y and fxy means this is suppose the candidate pixel which we want to update, or where is our mask. So next pixel is x plus 1, y means this one minus fxy. So if this is fxy, x plus 1, y is this one. So how we will write this? Z8 minus Z5. Similarly, gradient in y direction. Instead of x plus 1, x is as it is, y plus 1 minus the present pixel. That means y plus 1 means x is same and y plus 1 means next column. So if it is fxy, xy plus 1 is this pixel. So z6 minus z5. This is the gradient, and the first derivative is obtained by taking the magnitude of this gradient. Let us obtain magnitude of the gradient. Denoted by mod del f, magnitude of gradient. So it is square root of gradient in x direction, gradient in y direction, square. Gradient in x direction, gradient in y direction. This we obtained in the last slide. We'll take the mod. Now as it is a mod, we can write the reverse also, z5 minus z8, doesn't matter. So this is the magnitude of gradient, or we can say it is the first derivative. We can write in the form of mask. This is fxy pixel. So this is z5 minus z8. And this one is y directional, z5 minus z6. So this is the first gradient or first derivative mask. That means if we connole our image with this mask, we'll get the x-directional gradient. And if we'll connole with this mask, we'll get the y-directional gradient. Let's understand this concept graphically. This is a ramp-like structure of an edge in the image. This is our first derivative, that is the magnitude of the gradient. The first derivative at any point in an image or any point or any pixel in an image is obtained by magnitude of gradient at that pixel. So this graph represents magnitude of gradient at different pixels in an image, at different pixels of this edge profiles. We need to decide the edge pixels because we are detecting the edge. Here we are putting some threshold to detect the edge pixels. The pixels, all the pixels whose gradient lies in the range A to B, this is all the pixels whose gradient is in the range A to B are considered as a edge pixel. Thus, the local maximum in the first derivative decides the edge pixels, and all the other pixels which are not in a range of A to B are removed. So this is how to detect the edges by the gradient approach. The local maximum of gradient decides the edge pixels. Here I have taken one line profile in the image. Just one line, it is just one directional I have considered. So these are the intensities 0, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 7. How to obtain the first derivative or gradient? It is nothing but the first difference. This is x directional. So if it is fxy, x plus 1y is this one. So 0 minus 0, 0, then present pixel and next pixel. That is x plus 1. xy and x plus 1 y, 1 minus 0 1, 2 minus 1 1, 3 minus 1 1, 4 minus 3 1, like this, 7 minus 7 0. So we are considering the first gradient in x directional, and if you observe this, this is the gradually increasing pixel or intensities, that means ramp like structure. And for ramp-like structure, you will get the non-zero gradient. This is just example. So this is all about the how to find the first derivative of a image pixels by the local maximum gradient approach. Thank you.